Hi, Eric Gibbo, ericgibbo.com, and today I'm going to present you the fisheye lens for smartphone and iPhone by Sennmark. Let's start. Well, after this humoristic introduction, here's the box. So I want to say that Sennmark sent me this lens for free, but I still say whatever I want. I was already a client of Sennmark. I've bought several lenses from them, and then as they saw I was doing reviews, they sent me now for free their gear so I can review it. But as I have complete freedom to give my opinion. Okay, so what's in the box? Well, this lens can be used in two ways. One way is thought for iPhones. So when you actually buy your lens, you should indicate what iPhone you have, so they give you they include a case to put the lens on it. In case you don't want to use the case, or you don't have an iPhone, you can mount the lens on a clip that is also included. So you mount the lens on this, and then you place the clip in front of the camera of your phone, the camera you want to use. And here is the lens itself. It comes in a small pouch like this. So on one side you have the logo of Sennmark, and now they write fisheye on the other hand, on the other side. I'm not sure they do it on every lenses now, because the one I have, it's not written. So sometimes when I look in my bag to get a lens, I'm not sure which one it is. I have to check or touch or open it. Now they put it, so I guess they now write it on every small bag. Okay, in there you will also find a small cloth. This is, by the way, this is microfiber. You can actually use it to clean the lens, and this is also microfiber. You can also obviously use it to clean the lens. And here you have the lens itself with front cap and back cap. Okay, really nice metal, really nicely done. Okay, so a bit more of technical information. This lens in full frame would be the equivalent of 10 millimeter, and it actually covers 210 degrees. Yes, it's more than flat angle, it's 210. If you don't take care, you can actually see your feet in the picture. Okay, so it's really incredible. And if you compare to the ultra wide lens of the iPhone 11 Pro and Pro Max, that is given as a 0.5 magnification, and this is 0.2. actually, I don't know how they calculate it, but Sennmark says it's like 5 times more angle. I show you two pictures, one of the ultra wide and one with the fisheye, so you can actually see the difference. So when you're going to place the lens, it must go in front of the wide angle lens, whether you use the clip or whether you use the case. If your phone has only one lens, obviously you know which one to use. If you have tele and wide, use it with the wide. And if you have three lenses, three cameras like this iPhone, place it in front of the wide, not in front of the ultra wide. As you can see, placing the telephone in the case is really easy. Well, can you imagine? Okay, and that's it. Okay, so this case is really hard. I think it's important that it's this way, that kind of material, plastic, hard plastic with the metal reinforcement here, because it's very important that the lens is really steady, doesn't move, otherwise it would give some optical problems. I think that contrary to the first case they were doing, this one is a bit higher, a bit thicker, so it means that if the phone falls on it, flat on its glass, I think it won't break. I think it's protected. I would prefer to have it a bit higher maybe, but I think it's better than the first version they had. Okay, and anyway, I don't like that kind of case to have all day long, unless I'm going to do pictures and video all day, because I prefer the case with the cover. Okay, but it's a matter of taste. But this case I think is good quality. Placing the lens is really easy. You just take off the back cap, this one, and then you're going to screw it on the case, on this lens. Okay, very important, the first time you're going to use it, maybe you see it will be maybe a bit hard to enter the lens, to screw the lens. Do not force, because it seems to be aluminium. If you force, you may damage the mount, and then after it won't be sitting flat in front of the sensor. So go easy, feel how it screws properly, and then once you've done it once, it's not really a problem. There are not many turns. Yeah, I think it's like, I would say, a couple of turns to be placed properly. Yeah, thumbs and some, yeah, I think so, something like this. And then it's probably screwed on, okay? And then you can take this cap and then you can start making pictures or video. If you don't want to use the case, well, it's very easy, you can use a clip, whether because you don't have any iPhone, you have an Android phone, or because the iPhone you have, you don't have the case that corresponds to that iPhone. One thing, if one day you change iPhones, you can order the case separately. These come included, but you can get it separately. So you can use the clip for whatever reason that you cannot use the case, use the clip. Just simply screw it on the clip. Okay, then remove the front cap. Why? Because when you're going to place a lens, it's important that you can check that it's properly placed. So open your camera app. Okay, so you can check that it's properly centered, there is no vignetting or this. But as you can see, it's really easy to use and to place. Take into account that the angle is 210 degrees. It means you actually can see behind the lens. Not just behind it this way, but a bit back. It means if you actually take your phone this way, like this, okay, you will see your finger in the picture. So it's very important you hold the telephone like this, the smartphone like this, and your fingers are really behind, far behind the lens, otherwise it will show. Same thing if you make a picture or video and you put the camera, the telephone close to your body, you will see your feet and probably your chin also. So you must really put it a bit further. This is not an error, this is not a problem with the design of the lens. It's simply due that it's over 180 degrees. It will happen with any lens that has so many degrees, like 210, okay? But take it into account, because if you don't look at it properly, if you don't check carefully, you will have many pictures where you can actually see your fingers. As you can see on the picture that I'm showing you, the deformation, circular deformation is really important. This is not a mistake by this on this lens, this is all fisheye are this way. So if your idea was to make architecture pictures with a perfect straight line, this is not the lens you need. But if you want to give a more creative or more crazy or caricatural look to your pictures, this is a great lens. So it all depends what you're going to do. But take into account that deformation is really important, and this circle in the line give a strange effect that is interesting. This is why I think that it may be good to have at least one straight line in your picture. So the one that goes through the center will be straight. So if you're doing like an architecture or an horizon, whatever, try to pass it through the center of the picture. So this way it will be flat. And then you have the rest that is circle around. It gives you maybe something more interesting than if you don't have any straight line, maybe it looks really too crazy. But it's a matter of taste, experiment. This is my opinion. I mean, maybe you do something really different and it's more crazy and more fun. I'm not sure. So, but try this, to have at least one straight line, at least when you start. What amazes me is how close you can focus. I mean, the introduction of the video, the camera was about that far from me. This is incredible. But then I show you now some pictures I've made. On the floor there was a small piece of wood, and it almost touches the front lens, and as you can see, I can't even get out of focus part as being so close. So if you want to do some creative or different things without using a macro, if you do macro it would be probably a shallower depth of field, but the line will be straight normally. In this case I get the subject in focus and the rest out of focus, but the rest is circular deformation. So it's really creative, really different. I think it's great. Sharpness really surprised me. I know that sharpness is not the most important thing for many people, and for me either. But when you do like a very close up and you want to have a lot of sharpness on the subject, I think this is good because it stands out more. And I must say that you don't lose any sharpness of the original camera, your iPhone camera, when you place this lens in front of it. And that's a good point. You must take care of the front lens. As you can see, it stands out. And on fisheye lenses, not this one, on any fisheye lens, normally you cannot put any filter, any sunshade, nothing to protect. So when you're going to make a really close-up picture, make sure that the element you're making picture of, you're not touching the lens. And although the cap doesn't seem to touch the front of the lens, like some space, okay, to not stain it or scratch it, I think when you place it, always make sure it's really clean inside. There is no sand or whatever, because if space would not be enough, you actually turn it, you can actually scratch the front of the lens. So take great care of that. Not just this lens, but any fisheye lens has this thing. You must really be careful using it. The build quality is really good, as every lens I have from Saint Mark. I think it's metal construction, metal build. The glass seems really good. You see the coating, that's really nice. I think that you really see the difference between a lens like this and the typical cheap Amazon or eBay lens. And it justifies the price. Although I think the price is not really high. It costs $89 US dollars, this lens. That includes the case. So if you take into account that many cases, and normally they cost around 30 euros or $30. So I think it's a bargain. I think it's really great price. And the quality, the build quality is great. So regarding the use of fisheye lenses. Well, I've never been crazy for fisheye, because I think it's limited, it's really too specialized. So I never decided or wanted to buy a fisheye lens for my cameras, because I thought to spend like 500 or 400 or more euros on a fisheye lens, I didn't see it really useful for me or hard to justify. But then when I saw they actually had it for a smartphone, I thought, wow, that could be fun, and the price is reasonable. Although I didn't buy it when I ordered my first three Saint Mark lenses, I gave other priorities. But then I was like thinking, yeah, that would be fun to try that. So I asked Saint Mark if they would like me to review the lens. I said, okay, I'll send it to you. We'll send it to you. So I sent it. I thank them for that. And I think yes, on the smartphone is great, because first, the money is more limited, and second, because it doesn't take place. Fisheye on a camera, normal camera, is a lot larger, and it's fun to have it. I think I would recommend this lens, except if you have really specific fisheye project, then you would use it for everything. Don't abuse of it, but I still think it's really recommendable as a fun lens. You're a group of party of people and you want to make a face stand different or this, or you're in a really tight place and you want to have everything around, or you can put it in your microwave oven or in the washing machine. I'll show you a picture. I put it in the washing machine. So I think it's really fun to use. It's not easy to use, because you have to place properly your fingers and hand and body around the phone, but I think it's really fun, and I can only recommend this lens, at least as a fun lens. And then after, you can see if you can use it for other things than just fun and creativity, whatever. But it's really recommendable, and the quality is really good. So thank you very much, Saint Mark, for sending me the lens. Thank you very much to you for watching the video. If you feel it may interest other people, please share it on social networks. If you have not done yet, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, the small button down here, and also a small bell. If you click on the bell, you get notified when I upload a new video. My website, ericgibault.com. If you have any question, you can leave a comment below, send me an email to info@ericgibault.com. And below, I also leave you links of my gear on Amazon, and also links to other parts of my YouTube channel. Thank you very much. Take care of yourself. Bye.